Hey, what's going on, everybody? Jake here with Venter Visuals, and on this channel we break down popular music video editing techniques, tricks, and tips. Today we are going to be talking about how to use data moshing on your music video footage. I really love how this effect looks, especially on really high energy music videos. So today we are going to be using a plugin called Data Mosh 2 that I downloaded off of aescripts.com. I'll make sure to include a link for that below, and we're going to be trying this plugin out on a music video called Ransom. These video files were sent to me by a user I met through Instagram called XO Kaiser. I'll make sure to include his links in the description below if you want to check him out. He sent me this dope high energy music video with the cut already finished and just asked me to add some sauce to it. And I thought this would be a perfect example to show you guys how we can use data moshing on our music videos. So let's jump into it, guys. You can see we've already got the music video cut down pretty well here on the timeline. We've already got some effects thrown in here. These little green spots, I'm just using my transition presets from my blueprints pack, which you can download on VenterVisuals.com if you're interested. I'll go ahead and play a little section of this music video for you guys so you guys can kind of get the vibe. I'm gonna glow up on my own, I don't need no other little friends. They said, boy, you gotta come harder, gotta come way harder than them. They said, boy, you gotta come slaughter all these men. If I'm doing what they want, then I know something ain't right then. I'm gonna glow up on my own, I don't need no other little friends. So it's these high energy music videos that are just perfect for using these data mosh effects. So if I scroll back here in my timeline, I've actually done a few data mosh effects already. You can see right here as it kind of just blends with the clips right there. It's just like this glitchy pixel effect that is so dope. I also did it again right here. You can see the frames start to pixelize and, you know, it just gets all glitched out right there. All the pixels just go crazy right there. I'm gonna be adding some more of these data moshes around this timeline here. Let's find kind of this area in the song where there's not a whole lot going on yet. Other little friends. Huh. I need rest on rest on rest. So maybe like right there in between these two clips, there's nothing happening. He's just on the street. Then we got him again on the street in a slightly different outfit. So what I'm going to do is just highlight both these clips. I'm going to right click on them and I'm going to hit replace with After Effects composition. That's going to pull our clips directly here into After Effects. Once you download the Data Mosh 2 plugin, it's pretty easy and awesome to use. All you got to do is come up here to Window and you're going to come to Extensions, Data Mosh 2. We're just gonna click on that. That's gonna pull up our plugin over here on the left side. Probably the most basic way to use this plugin is gonna be to just select this box called Remove Frames, and then we're gonna hit this plus button right here to add a little point, a remove point. So we're just gonna drag this remove point to where these two clips intersect right here. And we're just gonna go ahead and hit data mosh. This is gonna give us our first mosh, so you guys can kind of start to get the idea. It's going to render the clip out in the After Effects rendering, and then it's also going to bake our mosh in the plugin itself. After it's done rendering and baking the mosh, it's going to create a new layer, and this is gonna be our mosh layer right here. So as I scroll over, you can start to see we're getting this crazy moshing effect that kind of transitions us into the next clip. This is the easiest way to start, you know, getting your data moshes set up on your timeline, but don't let this fool you. This plugin is super powerful. You can get really creative with it and get super customizable with it. So what I'm gonna do now is just hit Command S to save this back into Premiere Pro. That's gonna save it right back here into my timeline. And as you can see, it's red here on my timeline. So what I need to do to view this back at full speed is just come slightly to the left on my timeline. I'm gonna hit I for in. I'm gonna come slightly to the right of that red spot. I'm gonna hit O for out. And then I'm gonna come up here to sequence and hit render in to out. So now that it's rendered, you can see that it's all green. Let's check out what this data mosh looks like in full speed. So this is pretty awesome looking right here, but I almost want it to like end so it kind of slaps back into like the normal clip. I don't want it to be data mosh the full way through. So what I'm gonna do is just hop back here into After Effects. I'm gonna cut the data mosh clip up here at the top, maybe about, you know, 5 frames from the end. I'm gonna delete the rest of that data mosh so it goes back into this normal clip right here. And then what I can do if I wanna just kind of gradually ease this back into, you know, what it looks like regularly, I'm just gonna hit T on my keyboard to open up opacity, and I'm gonna keyframe the opacity of my data mosh layer from 100 down to 0. Now when I scroll over, it's going to kind of go right back into that clip. So it's going to start data moshed, and then it's going to kind of fade, dissolve into the actual clip. Now when I hit Command S, jump back here into Premiere Pro, I should see, you know, now we can see we got the actual clip at the end of that transition. And then this is also an overlay from my Blueprints pack as well, which you can download on my website and even try for free if you're interested. So now what I'm gonna do is hit Sequence, Render into Out. Let's check this out one more time. I think that looks really, really cool. And it's a lot smoother with the kind of like opacity dissolve there at the end. I think this is a really great transition for this edit. So the next effect I want to talk about is how to use data moshing and combine it with some rotoscoping. So you can see here in this earlier example that I did yesterday, I actually did a little bit of a rotoscope, and then I have the data mosh happening behind him. So it gives us even a more trippy kind of look here, where he remains in focus, but the background is data moshing. What I'm going to do is just take this clip of him standing right here in the street. This is gonna be a pretty easy rotoscope because he's, you know, very clearly visible here. It's not gonna take us very long. So what I'm gonna do from this point is I'm gonna right click on it and hit nest and hit okay. And then I'm gonna right click on it again and hit replace with After Effects composition. And now what I'm gonna do is just duplicate this layer in After Effects by hitting Command D. This bottom one, we're gonna call this one background / data mosh, and then this top one we'll go ahead and rename this rotoscope. First thing I'm going to do with this top layer, just come up here to my roto brush tool, and I'm going to double click, and what I'm going to do from here is just trace the outline of him. And you know, basically in 95% of my other tutorials on this channel, I'm doing some version of rotoscoping. I think it's a very common effect used in music videos, and it's really got limitless possibilities, as I'm about to show you here. When you combine it with a plugin like Datamosh 2, you can get some crazy, crazy results out of it. So I'm just gonna keep rotoscoping along the timeline here. And now that I'm at the last frame here, we've got to remember to switch back to our composition. And if I turn off the background layer, we can see our rotoscope cut out right here. It's not perfect. It's not the prettiest rotoscope I've ever done, but it'll be kind of hard to notice the imperfections with our data mosh happening in the background. So what we're going to do now is just turn on our background layer. For this one, we're actually just going to hide our rotoscope layer here. And with just the background layer visible, I'm going to come up here to Window, Extensions, Data Mosh 2. Instead of selecting the Remove Frames box for this one, we're actually just going to ignore that. And we're going to hit this plus icon right here. And this is where you can see all of the other Data Mosh presets. And, you know, I think there's over 60 of them in here that will give you different types of Data Mosh effects. So you can play around with this folder all you want. It's a pretty cool way to get a lot of unique looks quickly. For this particular effect, I think what will work really well is coming to the spatial folder and hitting multiply by Y. And that's gonna give us an in and out point here on this new layer, this new mosh layer right here. So we can adjust the in and out points for where we want this data mosh to occur. But because we're just doing it over one clip, I just want it to happen over the entire length of this clip in the background, because it's really not that long. We're just applying it to this one clip. Now, another really cool thing about this plugin is if you come to this drop down arrow, you can actually tweak the data mosh a little bit more to your liking. One thing I don't like about this plugin is that you cannot see the data mosh, what it'll look like as you're tweaking the settings. You have to render it out every single time. So getting a data mosh that you're actually comfortable with using in your edit might take a few tries. You might have to render out multiple data moshes to achieve the look that you're wanting to achieve, because with all of these options in here, the possibilities are truly endless. So you can get a lot of different types of effects and looks using this one plugin. But for this one, let's go ahead and try changing the intensity up. Let's change it up from 50 to 100. Acceleration is just gonna be how fast these pixels accelerate over time. I usually turn this up to like 15 or 20. And you'll see that like the pixels kind of start slow and then get faster as the clip moves. Blend is just going to be how much we want our background to blend with the original. And then threshold is basically telling the Data Mosh plugin whether or not we want certain pixels moving a certain speed to be data moshed as well. So if I put this at 30 with this threshold, pixels moving faster than 30, are going to get data moshed versus having it at zero where it's going to affect like all of the pixels in your frame. So I know this might sound a little confusing, and ultimately data moshing is pretty confusing. It's not really an easy concept to grasp. What I recommend is just playing around with this plugin a bunch. It's not the most practical plugin by any means, but for these types of music videos, I think they can really speed up the workflow and give us some really cool effects quickly. So what I'm gonna do now is with these settings, I'm just gonna hit data mosh here, and let's see how this one starts to look. We have our data mosh layer here on top. If I hit play, we can see how crazy this data mosh is starting to look. It looks freaking awesome, I would say, already. But the beauty of including a rotoscope layer on top of this is we get to kind of keep his shape separate from the data mosh. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn this rotoscope layer back on, and I'm actually just gonna move it to the layer above our data mosh layer that we just created. And now we can see that he is cut out from the rest of the data mosh. So the background is changing right here, right? It starts normal, and then it changes drastically to this data mosh, but he stays, you know, in focus, he stays normal. So you can get very, very creative, you know, with the combination of just a basic rotoscope and this data mosh plugin. Now all I'm gonna do is hit Command S, save that back into Premiere Pro. And then now that it's here in Premiere Pro, I'm gonna do a quick render here on my timeline. Now that I got this section of timeline rendered out, let's go ahead and preview what this part of our music video is going to look like with our newest data mosh. I just want to give a quick shout out to those of you in this community who are subscribed to the channel. We just hit 4,000 subscribers. I cannot believe it. I'm meeting so many of you through my Instagram as well, and it's been amazing getting to talk with you guys, seeing your portfolios, editing some of your guys' footage. It's just been a really, really awesome. And I'm very blessed to be in this position where I'm able to work with so many other creative people out there. If you're looking to sauce up your visuals today, definitely check out my website, venturevisuals.com. I have a free pack on there where you can sample all of my editing packs completely free of charge. I dropped my newest pack, Blueprints, a couple weeks ago. It's full of transitions and overlays. So if that's interesting, definitely check it out. It's one of my favorite packs yet to date, and it's been awesome to use on music videos like the one that you watched me edit today, just to help speed up the process and give me some ideas for where I want to take my edits. So if you're interested in any of that, definitely check out the links down below and comment below any types of tutorials that you would like to see me create. And until next time, guys, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.